The name of this story is Tick Mouse, and it relates to the fact that the existing world was flooded and the efforts of the bird and animal people to dive to the bottom of the ocean that, you know, covered the new earth and make a new world. And this here story has a lot of comments about how the various birds and animals, you know, did different things to, you know, make efforts to gather the earth from the bottom of the ocean. And it also talks about, in the beginning, how come the earth flooded and what happened and so forth. Tick Mouse. A long time ago, when the earth was young, people and animals lived together in the Chehalis Valley near Oakville. There was this village. In this village were birds, people, animals. In those days, everybody could talk and live together, and they were friends. Well, in this village, there was the daughter of the chief, and she is a very beautiful lady. In the morning, she'd go for a walk and maybe work in the garden or things like that. And all the young men in the village would want to fall in love with her, you know, like maybe Elk Boy and Beaver Boy and People Boys and things like that. And they'd all want to go talk to her. And what she would do is, you know, talk to them and be friendly and sociable. But no one ever, you know, caught her attention. In the evening, then, her mother and father would talk to her and say, "Daughter, you know, there's a lot of people interested in marrying you. You should get ready to make your choice and choose somebody." And she said, "No, I haven't met that man yet." So in the morning, she'd get up and do the same routine, walk down to the garden, go over here, go over there, do this and that, and talk to all the young men who were following her around. Well, on several of these travels, when she might go to the river, there would be this rock. And as she passed this rock and looked at, you know, this person that was on the rock, there was this man called Tick Mouse. And he would be sitting there, and he might be working on something, you know, like a basket or a carving or a drawing or something. And he'd just be working and working and working. She would come by, and she'd look at him, and he wouldn't notice her. She'd walk real slow, and he wouldn't notice her. She might want to pretend like she'd tired and sit nearby, and he wouldn't notice her. And she got intrigued. So after several trips, she sat next to him, says, "Tick Mouse, how come you never talk to me?" He says, "I've been watching you go by here. I see all the young men visiting you and talking to you, and I know that I don't possess their qualities. I'm not attractive. I'm not a fast runner. I'm not, you know, this, I'm not that. I'm just me, and all I can do is do these things I do on this rock." And he says, "I didn't think that these were the qualities that would interest you. So there was no need for me to waste my time. I'm just going to keep on being me." Well, that lady went away, and she'd walk here and she'd walk there, and all the young wind would still be following her. Then she'd walk by that rock, and Tick Mouse would be there, so they'd talk some more. Finally, she started getting interested in him, getting attracted to him. You know, he possessed the qualities that she was interested in. So she goes home and talks to her mom and dad, says, "Mom and Dad, you know, I found this young man that, you know, I'd like to get more serious about. Maybe I'd like to bring him home." Everybody got excited, and they were saying, "Oh, wow. Who is this man? Is he a fast runner? Is he a good fisherman? Can he do this and can he do that?" And she says, "No, you might know him, though. It's Tick Mouse." Everybody looked at her and said, "Who?" "Tick Mouse, the man that sits on the rock in the daytime and does those carvings and basket works." "Yeah, that's the one." "And you're interested in him?" "Yeah, I sure am. I'd like to get to know him better." She says, "Well, daughter, you can't go do that. You can't see him anymore. That's not a good choice. You have to choose somebody else." So that lady, that princess, you know, the daughter, she goes down the next day, and she's sitting on the rock, and she says, "Tick Mouse, you know, I'm really interested, you know, and I've talked to my parents about maybe having you come home and visit me, but they don't approve of you. It doesn't look good, and I really feel sad. I wish there was something we could do. Maybe we could run away or something." He says, "No." He says, "Let me think about this." Let me see what we can do. I'll tell you, but give me a couple of days to think about this. So she went home, and they said, now you told that tick mouse you can't see him anymore. And she says, no, I didn't say it that way. And she says, well, you told tick mouse you can't be serious at all. And she says, no, I didn't say it that way either. He says, well, we told you, we don't want you to see him. We don't want you to get interested in him. We don't want you to have anything to do with him. Just leave him alone. Find somebody else. So a couple of days pass, and she goes down that trail again. There's that rock, and there's the tick mouse. And she says, well, what did you think about? What's your plan, and what can we do? He says, well, I'm going to sing a song, and I'm going to make it rain. I'm going to make it flood. And those people will see how good my power is, and then they'll let you and me marry. She says, well, this is Western Washington. It already rains. It already floods. That's nothing new. He says, you haven't seen a rain and a flood like this. When are you going to start? I'll start tomorrow. So Tick Mouse was there. Morning came, that lady came down, and she had told her parents that, you know, he was going to do something the next day. So there's a lot of people on the hill watching, going to see what was going to happen. Like he was going to get mad or throw a rock or, you know, hit somebody over the head or something. And they were wondering, what can he do that's going to be so good to make us change our mind, show us his power? Well, Tick Mouse was sitting there, and she said, when are you going to start? He says, now, I guess. I'll show you. He got out his drum, and he started singing. Whoa-yo-ho-way-yo-ho, rain, rain, come every day, rain, rain, rain all the time. He started singing that song. Everybody was on top of the hill, and they was watching. It's going to make it rain. It's going to flood. That happens all the time here. That's nothing good. That's nothing new. And they all laughed, and they left. The parents left, and all the other villagers left. So just that lady was there. And she says, well, it's raining a little bit. How long is it going to rain, and how hard, and how high will the water be? He says, when we're done, you'll see. So he kept on singing that song. Rain, rain, rain all the time. Rain, rain, rain real high. Flood, flood, come very high. And next day, people came, and they said, boy, that was a pretty good storm last night. Must be 2 or 3 inches. And everybody says, how long is it going to last? 3 or 4 days? So, you know, everybody went home again, and that tick mouse was there, and that lady was sitting there. And they kept on singing. So after about 3 or 4 days, you know, they came back, and they said, boy, that's real good singing there, tick mouse. Now the water must be, you know, the rain must be about, 2 feet deep. And the water must be about 10 or 15 feet high. But how much longer can you sing? And he kept on singing. He didn't say anything. He just kept on singing. And that lady says, well, this is looking better. She says, that's a lot of water in the valley. And he says, I'm not done yet. And he kept on singing. So after about 2 weeks, the people came back. They said, boy, it must have rained 5 feet already, and the water must be up 30 feet, 40 feet. That's really good, but when are you going to stop? And he kept on singing. Oh, a couple days later, they came back, and now the water is getting close to the village. And they said, all right, Tick Mouse, you've done well. This is a good song, but you should maybe think about stopping before you hurt us. And he just kept on singing. So next day, they looked, and water is even higher. So the people went in the village, and they went and got their canoes. They started loading the canoes, you know, putting in the food and putting in sleeping bags, putting in this and that and all their things that they wanted to save. Other people started getting higher up on the hill, you know, moving the village. And the mother and the father were still sitting there watching and wondering, you know. And finally, you know, the tick mouse kept on singing. Well, we don't know how many days that he sung. But some people say that he sung for 40 days and 40 nights. But anyway, the world was flooded. All the people were in their canoes, and when you sat in that canoe and you looked over here and you looked over there, you couldn't see anything but water. There were no more mountaintops. Finally, Tick Mouse says, well, that's my song. That's all I'm going to sing. So everybody's in these canoes, 10, 15 canoes, and they're all together. And they said, now what are we going to do, Tick Mouse? He says, well, whoever can swim to the bottom of this land or bottom of this water that can get a piece of dirt, I'll make into a new earth. Everybody says, well, how deep is it? They said, it must be pretty deep because you can't see the mountains anymore. And they says, who's the best swimmer? Everybody was looking around. They said, well, this should be a pretty easy job for a good swimmer. Who wants to go first? So Otter was there. He said, well, I got a few minutes. I guess I can dive down there. So everybody was watching. He said, yeah, Weasel or Otter, you go ahead and do this. You're a good swimmer. This will be easy for you. So they all got their canoes out, and they all got their drums. They started singing power songs. And they said, you know, hop in, Otter, dive deep, swim hard, breathe long, and grab that earth and come back. And they all were singing their song, and Otter hopped in. He was gone. He was gone a long time. They said, boy, maybe he's gone for, you know, maybe he had died or maybe he had been injured. They said, boy, he's been gone a long time. And they were getting worried, nervous, looking around. They said, where is that Otter at? And finally he comes up. And they said, Otter, what did you see? He said, didn't see anything. Everybody felt sad. They said, well, we got more swimmers. Other people can go. And they said, who else wants to go? And Elk Boy says, well, I'm a pretty good swimmer. So Elk Boy, you know, got on top of that canoe, and everybody sung their songs again. And Elk Boy flopped in. But, you know, animals, you know, like, elks don't swim very good. So Elk Boy was only gone just a little bit. And he come up. He says, I didn't see anything. They said, that's okay. That was a good try, Elk Boy. So they had more people come in. And even birds wanted to try. Like Owl was there. He said, well, I can do this. I'll hop in. But all Owl did was to get in, and he made a big old flop and about drowned. So they had to grab him and pull him out. So other people went, and one person that went down, I'm trying to think of his name, but he went down and he came back. He says, wow, I did see the bottom of the water. I did see the land. I was real close, but I didn't make it. Maybe if I rest, I'll go again and try. That gave hope to all the people in the boats. They said, oh, wow, this can be done. We'll try and we'll see. Well, Muskrat was there. He says, well, I'm about the only one left. It should be my turn. Let me try. Everybody looked at Muskrat, and they said, Muskrat, you? You know, because he's a small animal. He's not a very good swimmer. He's not very fast. And they all started laughing. He says, no, everybody's had their chance. If you help me sing my song, I'll try it. But no one would help him sing his song, so he had to sing his song by himself. And he was up there on top, and he sung his song, and he hopped in. Well, of all the animals and birds and animals that hopped in, Muskrat was gone the longest. He was, you know, gone even longer than Otter. And they said, gosh, maybe he got hurt. Maybe something happened. Maybe he won't make it back. He was really gone a long time. So they're almost ready to give up hope. And all of a sudden, they seen the bubbles coming up. And Otter was there, and they fished him out. And in his hand, he had a little bit of dirt. And they looked, and they said, wow, he did do it. But it wasn't enough earth to make the new earth. And he says, you got to go again, Otter. So he rested a day or two, and this time everybody helped him sing a song. He dives to the bottom of the water again. He's gone as long. He comes back. He's only got a little bit more dirt. Not enough yet. So Muskrat has to make three trips. Finally, it comes back. They fish him out, and they look, and there's all this dirt. And Tick Mouse was saying, well, it looks like we have enough dirt to make this earth. I'll sing my song, but before I do this song, you have to, you know, he's talking to Mom and Dad now. He says, you have to let me know that I can marry this daughter of yours. And they said, boy, with your power, you can do anything you want. So Muskrat Our tick mouse got on the boat. He says, now this is what we're going to do. We're going to start singing our song. He says, and when I sing this song, I'm going to start spreading the dirt on the water. And in the beginning, it's only going to be a small piece of land. And we're going to have to reach down, pick up that land. We're going to have to make new land. And after it gets big enough that we can stand on it, then all of us can get on that land and we all have to help make new land. They said, okay, start singing our song. So he started making that song and everybody was singing and they were saying, make the new earth, make the new earth, make the new earth. And Titmouse was there and he was going like this, using his hand and spreading that dirt. And pretty quick there's dirt on the water. And it got bigger and bigger. And when there was, you know, big enough maybe for two people, someone would get on and help and they'd pick up more dirt and keep on spreading it. And then, you know, finally it was big enough for the village and everybody was out there helping and, you know, spreading this dirt. Well, anyway, the big animals were there. Oh, you know, like maybe bear was out there and wolverine was out there and, you know, just people that, oh, I don't know that they were clumsy or slow or lazy or something, but bear was out there. And he says, well, we're going too slow. We got to make this earth real good. He says, watch me. I'll show you how you do this. And he took his old big claw, and instead of taking the dirt and smoothing it out and making valleys and, you know, level land, he just took the clumps. He just started throwing it out and making mountains, you know, like big mountains like Mount Rainier and Mount St. Helens and, you know, the Cascades. He was, you know, that was where Bear was working. He was just not a very good job at all. But where you could see the ants were working, you know, that was real good river bottom land, real good valley land. And then the other people were working, and they finally kept on going, and the new earth was made. And that's when that tick mouse married that lady. But what happened here was that he had discounted himself. You know, he didn't give himself as much value as he should have. That lady seen past that and was willing to be with him. But, you know, the parents, when they looked at him, they discounted him also. They're like, he's not very good, he's not very pretty, he's not very fast, all of those things. But after he made his song, had the world flooded, and then he told them how they could get the earth back. And Muskrat went down and got the land and brought it back. And then he says we could have a good earth except for Bear helping out and other people that just threw the clods everywhere. They did real good. And this story here, if it could be called an origin story, would be the origin story for the Hazel Pete family. But we never had a story how come we were here in the first place. Grandma and Grandpa never said that. They just said, here's what Titmouse did and flooded the land.